One of the most useful things that you can add to your form in a model-driven Power App is the ability to see related records. So if I'm looking at an account, I want to see all of the contacts that are associated with that, and I want to put it on the form in a way that makes it really front and center and easy for the user. Remember, good design, good user experience. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create what are called subgrids to show related records on your form, and stick around to the end because we're also going to have a look at how we can use subgrids to make it easier for the user to create those records straight from the main form. So we saw in the intro the out-of-the-box experience where we start with an account and we can very easily see, in two places actually, the related contacts right on the form. That's out of the box, but if you're creating your own tables in your own app, you need to build those things, and that's where subgrids come in. Now, if you don't have a subgrid, you'll have an experience like this. Here's my equipment ordering app, and I want to see for this piece of equipment, what are all of the related orders? Now, I don't have it on my form, which means the user would have to come in here and go to the related menu and then choose it from that menu. And then the resulting associated view here is kind of useless out of the box, to be honest. Order references the name and the created on date, which doesn't really tell me anything at all. Plus, forcing the user to have to go into that related menu all the time for common things is just extra clicks, and it doesn't help anyone get the most out of the app. So let's go ahead and build a subgrid and give our user here a much better experience. And as always, we start in make.powerapps.com. We go into our solution that we've built for our model-driven app, and we open the solution. First thing I'm going to do is just zoom this up a little bit so it's easier to see what we're doing. Good tip down the bottom there. And then I'm going to go into my components menu and add a one column tab because we want this to be a wide subgrid across the tab. We select that tab and give it a name. So we're working here with equipment orders, and then we click inside that section. Now back to our components menu, and I can choose subgrid. What I'm going to get here is a list of all of the other tables that are in the system. And the first thing I want to do is to say show related records. Now you can actually use a subgrid to show any records on here. Mostly though, you're going to want to see things that are related to that main table rather than just some random other table in the system. So we click show related records, and then our list of tables here will only show me the things that are related to this. Now there's a lot of stuff in here you might not recognize. I've got a very basic app going on. A lot of out-of-the-box activities and things that you can work with here, so don't freak out if you see more there than you've created. But there's the one I'm looking for, equipment orders. Now I can choose here which view I want them to see. Check out my other videos for setting up views if you're not sure how that works. With this one, all I've got is the active and inactive, the standard things that came with that. So we're going to go ahead and click done, and that will drop that in there. Now, I have some other choices here. Firstly, let's deal with the headings and labels. And notice here we've got two layers of headings. So there is a heading here, this useless kind of new SG control thing that is the name of the header of the subgrid. And then we've also got the header of the section. So you can choose if you want to use both or neither of those. So let's work with the header on the subgrid here. So instead of this in the label, we're going to call this one equipment orders. And then I don't need another level of heading in here. So I'm going to go into my section and just hide that label. Back to my subgrid, and let's have a look at the other options available to us here. I've chosen the active equipment orders, which is my default view that's out of the box, but I can choose to say, do I want the users to be able to choose a different view? So when they go in, they can actually select something else. And if I enable that option, then I get a couple of other options here. Do I want to show all of the views, or do I want to just select the ones that are available? So in this case, I've only got two, it would be the same, but if I had more views in there, I could choose the ones that I want my users to be allowed to choose from. In this case, I'm going to say, sure, they can choose all of them. We can also set the maximum number of rows, which defaults to four, which means you'll see four related records in there. Have a think about what kind of records are here and how long this list is going to be and how many other things you might want to fit on this tab. If this tab is just this and perhaps four pieces of equipment, in my scenario here, I could have dozens and dozens of orders. It makes more sense to expand that out. Otherwise, the person is having to click next, next, next and go through. My preference here is to go for at least 10. I'm going to hit 20 because I've got nothing else on the screen, so that you get that longer list without the user having to flip through multiple screens. All right, that's it. Subgrid done. So let's save and publish and have a look at that on our form. How much better is this? Now I'm a user. I come and have a look at the equipment and I think, oh, I wonder how many orders we've had for this, and I can just click on that tab right there and my orders come up. Now, top tip here, you'll notice that this has got the name of the equipment in it. So in the context of looking at all of the orders, I want to see all of the different names of the equipment. But in the context of looking at Super Ergonomic Desk Chair Red, and I'm looking at the orders that go with that, what's going to happen here with this view is that I could have 20 lines here, and the first piece in every single line is going to be Super Ergonomic Desk Chair Red, which is repetitive and useless. So what I suggest you do, go back into your equipment ordering table, create a view specific to this. Have a think about when you create your subgrid, which columns do you want on the subgrid? You don't have to be constrained to just using the main view or the active items view. And in fact, I think it's better if you put something in here that's specifically designed for this. The other awesome thing that we can do with subgrids is allow the user to quickly create one of these related records right from here. So I'm looking at the equipment, I want to go ahead and create an order, and I can click on this button and do it right from this screen. That will mean that I'm creating the record from equipment. It already knows that it's linked and creates that link. So this saves time, data entry, makes everything really good. If you don't see this button, or if when you click on it, this happens, takes you away from that screen, opens a whole other screen, then there's a setting that you need to enable, which is called Quick Create Forms. You really want to do this because otherwise you're flicking back and forth or you're missing this option entirely. Let's have a look at how we do that. Back in my solution here, I want to click into that equipment order table, which is the table that I'm trying to create, not the one I'm trying to create it from. And if I go into forms, this is not my main form, there's other types of forms in here. I'm going to go and add a form, and the thing I want is called a quick create form, but it's grayed out. That's no good to me at all. So we have to enable this setting for this table. You'll find for accounts and contacts, it's already enabled out of the box. But for anything that you create, you just need to do this one-off setting once the first time. So we're going to go into the settings for the table. We're going to venture here into advanced options and then scroll down until we find the option here called Leverage Quick Create Form if available. Tick that, save that. And then there's one more thing we need to do before we're going to be able to use it, which is guess what? Publish. Often have to publish things. So let's just navigate back to the top level of our solution by clicking on the All button there and then click on Publish All Customizations. We just give that a little minute to run. I'm going to jump ahead so we see what's next. All right, green bar, we're all happy. So now I'm going to go back into my equipment order table. And this time when I choose forms, that quick create option is now available. Now a quick create form is designed to just pop up on the right hand side of the screen to give the user a really quick experience of doing their data entry. Keep it simple. There's not a heap of fancy stuff you can do here. It's a one column form with three sections. That's all you got. You can't add extra columns and extra sections in here. So all we want to do here is bring in the things that are necessary for quick data entry. Don't feel you have to put everything on the form. Nice and easy. So we go across into our table columns here and we bring across the things that we want. So in this case, I want to bring across the equipment, the order date, and the order reference number. And then let's just tidy up that label because I don't want a label there and I certainly don't want it to say new section. All right, when I'm happy, save and publish. And then when you're back in your solution, the list of forms for this table, you'll now see that there is a quick create form there. Let's check out what the experience is for the user now. Back in my app, here's my subgrid. And this time when I click on that new button, I get my quick create form on the side. How much better is this? I can just put in the order reference number, select the date, select who's placing the order, save and close, and it appears in the grid. You'll notice when I did that, it had already linked it up from that equipment, Super Ergonomic Desk Chair Red. I didn't have to do that data entry. As a bonus, you've now also given the user the ability to quickly create that record from anywhere within the app. This little plus at the top here now shows you equipment order as well as accounts and contacts. I can go in there and just go ahead and create that. Now, if it's out of context, it doesn't know which equipment it is, but I can just do that data entry from there. Now that you know how to create subgrids, the next thing I want to teach you is how to create a quick view form. You'll see a quick view form here. It allows you to see details from one of those related records right on the main form. It's a confusing sounding name, a quick view form, but it's really, really easy to build. Check out my next video. I'll take you through it. I'll see you there.